receive the royal scepter, the ensign of kingly power and justice. Receive the rod of equity and mercy. Be so merciful that you be not too remiss. So execute justice that you forget not mercy. O God, the crown of the faithful, bless, we beseech thee, this crown, and so sanctify thy servant Elizabeth, upon whose head this day thou dost place it for a sign of royal majesty.
Shall the Queen go to her throne and be lifted up into it by the archbishops and bishops and other peers of the kingdom.
I, Geoffrey, Archbishop of Canterbury, will be faithful and true. Faith and truth will bear unto you, our sovereign lady, queen of this realm, and defender of the faith, and unto your heirs and successors according to law. So help me God.
Your liege man of life and limb, and of earthly worship, and faith and truth I will bear unto you, to live and die, against all manner of folk, so help me God.
Thank you.
Now Queen Elizabeth, crowned and anointed, goes to receive communion. The Queen enters into St. Edward's Chapel for the recess. Into the crowd. Our love will shield you. Our voices cheer you. Our prayers uphold you. Our hearts be with you. These are the simple words of an ordinary woman in the crowd as Queen Elizabeth, arrayed in her robe of purple velvet, wearing the imperial crown and carrying the scepter and the orb, begins her stately progress home to Buckingham Palace. Their spirits undampened, the hundreds of thousands who have defied the elements for hours still roar their welcome to Her Majesty. Canada sent 786 officers and men in uniform, including the inevitable favorite with the crowds, the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Four of the Mounties also provided an escort for the Canadian Prime Minister. there was a picturesque procession of the colonial rulers, and high among them in public popularity was Her Majesty the Queen of Tonga. So Queen Elizabeth, in state and splendor, is escorted to her home. Londoners and people who have traveled thousands of miles to see her go by mingle in the crowds who have waited in unkind weather to cheer. Many there are who will speak with pride to their children and grandchildren in the years to come, telling how they saw Queen Elizabeth at her coronation, living again the memory in their hearts. with full hearts we salute this young, gracious lady upon whom the royal obligation rests. As she comes forth now upon the balcony of Buckingham Palace, before which, by tradition, the people come together to express their feelings. But deepest of all, the picture in our memories will be of the regal young queen, radiant and resplendent, the very spirit of the new age in this ancient abbey. For her, for us, the future beckons. Elizabeth is queen. Long may she reign.